There are an estimated 322 million people in this world that suffer from depression, but only half of them respond to treatment. Why is that? Scientists at Hiroshima University recently discovered something that could lead to better and more focused types of treatment for these people. RGS-8 is a protein that could be at the core of millions of cases of depression. 90% of prescription antidepressants are meant to treat low levels of serotonin and norepinephrine in the brain. These neurochemicals, or a lack thereof, are thought to be the main causes of depression. And while this is true in many cases, over 30% of the people who take these drugs don't respond to them at all. So what this new study suggests is that for some people, depression isn't linked to these chemicals, and so the drugs that are meant to treat them don't work. Dr. Yumiko Sato and her team discovered that RGS-8 controls a hormone receptor in the brain known as MCHR1. MCHR1 is important in regulating your mood, your eating habits, your sleep patterns, and your motor movements. And as anyone who's experienced depression before knows, these play a significant role in the development of disease. Because when you're depressed, you may have an altered mood, trouble sleeping, trouble eating, and feel lethargic. Dr. Sato and her team discovered that RGS-8 has the ability to inactivate the hormone receptor. And when the hormone receptor is inactivated, the symptoms of depression became worse. This led to the theory that decreased amounts of RGS-8 leads to an increased chance of experiencing depression. And so their hypothesis: changing the amount of RGS-8 in the body would affect a person's likelihood of experiencing depression. And so they ran a series of tests on mice. One group was modified to have increased levels of RGS-8, and the other was a control group. After the test, they discovered that the mice with increased levels of this protein had far fewer signs of depression. Another interesting discovery is that in the brain scans of the mice, those that were engineered to have more RGS-8 were not only less depressed, they also had longer cilia in the cells of their hippocampus. Cilia are organelles that are known to aid in cellular communication. Dysfunctional cilia are known to be linked to obesity and kidney problems, but this new finding suggests they might be linked to mood disorders as well. And if RGS-8 can help maintain cilia, then this is a very big step in the field of mental health research. And that is definitely a positive thing.